Welcome to July. This month has so much to offer if you like taking pictures of the night sky. In this video, I'll tell you about the best things to aim your camera at this month. First up, we have the Lagoon Nebula, also called Messier 8 or NGC 6532. The Lagoon Nebula is a truly amazing giant cloud in space found in the group of stars called Sagittarius. It's really a popular thing to photograph because it's so bright that you can actually just barely see it with your eyes, your naked eyes in the dark skies. This is 4,000 to 6,000 light years away from us, and guess what? It looks twice as big as the full moon in the sky. Nearby is the Trifford Nebula, also called Messier 20 or NGC 6514. This is a cool cloud of gas and dust where new stars are being born. You'll find it right next to the Lagoon Nebula, also in the constellation Sagittarius. What makes this Trifford Nebula so special are the dark dust lanes that cut right through it. They make it look like it has three different parts. That's where it gets its name Trifford from. Because of how cool it looks and its amazing colors, especially those pretty blues and reds, is one of my favorite targets. It's about 5,200 light years away from us. Next up is the Eagle Nebula, also called Messier 16 or NGC 6611. This is a stunning cloud of gas and dust where new stars are actively being made. You'll find it in the constellation Serpens, which looks a bit like snake in the sky. What makes the Eagle Nebula so famous are its tall structures called the Pillars of Creation. These giant columns of gas and dust in space became famous from amazing pictures taken by the Hubble Space Telescope. They literally look like fingers reaching up into space, and inside them, new baby stars are actually forming. This amazing star factory is about 5,700 to 7,000 light years away from us, and it's truly a grand sight to explore with its glowing gases and cool shapes. Let's talk about the Hercules Cluster, also known as Messier 13 or NGC 6205. This is a truly amazing ball of stars. It's what we call a globular. Can't say it. Globular. Oh, goodness me. That one. That cluster. Globular. Okay, I'll try again. Globular cluster, which means it's a very old and very tightly packed group of stars, all held together by gravity, and you'll find it in the constellation Hercules. What's really amazing about the Hercules cluster is just how many stars it has. They're all squished together in a pretty small space. This makes it one of the brightest and most impressive clusters you can see from Earth, especially if you're in the northern part of the world. If you have clear and dark sky, you might even be able to spot the Hercules cluster with your naked eyes, just as a faint, blurry spot of light. This incredible cluster is quite far away. It's about 22,000 light years away from us, at least. Now let's talk about the Milky Way Core. This is the very middle part of our galaxy, the Milky Way. It's not one single object like a cluster or a nebula, but instead a super dense and very active part of space. You can find it in the direction of the constellation Sagittarius, which is why many amazing objects like the Lagoon Nebula are seen there. What makes the Milky Way Core so special is that it's home to a super massive black hole called Sagittarius A. This black hole is millions of times bigger than our sun. Around it, stars are packed incredibly close together. Gas and dust clouds are spinning, and there's a lot of strong action and energy going on there. Because there's so much dust and gas between us and the very center, we can't actually see the black hole or the core's immediate area directly with our eyes in normal light. The dust blocks the view. However, scientists use special telescopes that can see in different kind of light, like radio waves, infrared, and X-rays, to look through the gas and dust and study this interesting area. When you look towards Sagittarius in a very dark sky, far away from light pollution and city, what you are seeing is the brightest, thickest part of our Milky Way. This glowing band of light is the combined light of billions of stars closer to the galaxy's middle. It is truly amazing sight, especially during the winter months of June, July, and August, when the galaxy center is high overhead and gives you a spectacular view of our home galaxy's heart. Let's move on to the North American Nebula, also called NGC 7000 or Caldwell 20. This is a giant cloud of glowing gas where new stars are forming. It gets its name because if you look at it in a right formation, it looks just like the continent of North America. You can find it in the constellation Cygnus. What makes this nebula so interesting is its recognizable shape, complete with a Gulf of Mexico, or at least that's what it was called before, made by a dark lane of dust. This dark dust hides some of the brightest parts of the nebula from our view, creating those clear outlines. It's often seen next to its neighbor, the Pelican Nebula, as they are actually part of the same giant space cloud, just separated by their dust. A wide field telescope might be best for this target, as it's so big it might not fit entirely. The beautiful red glow you see in the pictures of the North American Nebula comes from hydrogen gas that is being lit up by very hot stars. This amazing spot in space is about 1600 light years away from us. Next, we have the Whale Nebula. This is like the ghostly remains of a huge star that blew up a very long time ago, thousands of years back. It's also known by names like the Cygnus Loop. What makes the Whale Nebula so special are its see-through thin shapes. It looks like a torn curtain or a delicate whale glowing softly. These glowing threads are actually shock waves from the star's old star's explosion still spreading out into space. You can use a special oxygen filter to capture this properly. This filter will help you make the nebula's faint glow stand out against the dark sky. The Whale Nebula is quite far away, roughly 1400 to 2600 light years from. Finally, we'll look at the Crescent Nebula, also called NGC 6888 or Caldwell 27. This is a beautiful glowing space bubble of gas and dust. It's not from a star blowing up, but instead from a very big, hot, and unstable star. You can find it in the constellation of Cygnus. What makes the Crescent Nebula so interesting is how it's made. A powerful stellar wind, which is like a super strong rush of particles from the central massive star, is pushing against gas that the star lost earlier in its life. This crash creates a shock wave, heating up the gas and making it glow in a crescent or half moon shape. That's why it's called that. The red and blue-green colors often seen in the pictures of the Crescent Nebula come from glowing hydrogen and oxygen gas. This spectacular space bubble is thought to be around 4,700 light years away from us. Make sure you mark your calendars for the best viewing time, July 19th to July 27th. During these days, there won't be any bright moonlight to wash out faint clouds, galaxies, and star group. These are great conditions for wide field astrophotography and seeing the Milky Way. You'll also find it's the best time to see objects like the Lagoon Nebula.